So.
Hold on.
So.
Hold on.
Today, I was actually going to cover some defense. How to defend yourself against a barrage of punches. Right, I might cover that briefly, but during my session, I just reminded myself about something, a mistake that I always make, all the time. A little bad technique that I've got, and something I see a lot of people doing as well. And every time I watch my videos back, I see that I'm making the same mistake over and over again. And every time I go to a new gym, anywhere around the world, I go to Thailand, Australia, my pad men, my coaches in those gyms always tell me off for making this same mistake. So I'm going to cover my mistake first, and then I'm going to work on some defense. Boom, boom, boom. How to defend yourself when somebody's thrown a barrage of punches at you. This is great for the street. It's great for street fight defense. Obviously, it's also great for competition. Hold up. Right, this is what it is. And I often make the same mistake all the time whenever I watch my videos back. And that's why it's good to make videos of your training regime, because you tend to pick up on the little mistakes that you're making. Personally, one thing I do all the time and I always get told off about is how I throw my straight right. I tend to throw my straight right by chicken winging. And when I say chicken winging,
chicken winging.
Chicken winning, chicken winging. When I chicken wing,
this is what I mean before I throw my right hand, my straight right.
I tend to do this, and so basically I'm telling my opponent what I'm about to do. After a few shots, he's gonna figure out that yes, Les is gonna throw a straight right. And this is the same for most people out there. This is what I tend to do. Before I throw the right, I set, I chicken wing, and then I throw it. Terrible technique. Boom! So I'm making my straight right into two movements rather than just one. So that movement straight away is letting your opponent know, well, he's about to throw something and then I'm throwing. While basically you should be throwing it from here, down, boom, boom. It should look like that. In tight, guard up, boom, boom. It's coming from here, out, and you're only twisting to land the two knuckles at the very last moment of the punch. That's when you twist over. I tend to twist my knuckle out ready to land before I've even thrown it. Bad technique. And I'm going to show you how to get around that bad technique. A way to stop you from throwing that right hand. Basically, I've just spent 8 rounds of this morning session working on tightening up my straight right. Boom. The goal of this is to train yourself to keep your guard up at all times and launch your straight right, or if you're a southpaw, your straight left, without telegraphing, without chicken winging.
Chicken winging. Chicken wing. Chicken winning, chicken winging.
The point of this is to launch your power hand, your back hand, your straight hand, without chicken winging. Chicken winging. Chicken winging. So I'm going to show you a little technique. First off, you have to do this shadow boxing and not focus on power, focus more on your technique. So just cool off, calm down, and then throw it nice and relaxed. There. 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 Other side. If you're southpaw, so it's at the last minute, you're turning, you're just about to land, you turn your fist over to land with your two power knuckles. I'm gonna show you another little technique.
I'm gonna do this against the bag, so you can see. And then I'm gonna
show you another little technique that I like to
use to keep, which I've been using today to keep my technique right.
Hands in, hands tight, body covered, guard up, head covered, temples covered, in tight, shoulder out, chin tucked in, and hopefully I'm not chicken winging.
Here's one thing I do. I'll go on this other bag to show you a technique that I've been working on today to stop me from chicken winging, especially when I'm trying to throw those power shots. Naturally, if you're used to chicken winging, your body naturally wants a chicken wing as soon as you start knocking your technique out. As soon as you start getting tired, your body starts doing what you've been doing for years. Chicken winging. So personally, this is what I've been working on today. And you can work these both styles in southpaw and orthodox. Here's how best way to work it. Stand close to a bag or a wall or any physical hard or any hard object, any static object. Stand next to it and then throw your shots from there. You're gonna know, this is basically gonna tell you straight away if you're chicken winging or not. Because if you do chicken wing, that's what's gonna happen. You're gonna move the bag. You don't wanna move the bag. You wanna be there, guard up, and keep it in tight. Make sure the bag's touching your shoulder, tricep, your arm in general, and then throw it from there. See that? Boom, boom, boom. Throw it from there. Boom, boom, boom. Throw it from there, and back. Boom. So I'm keeping it tight. Boom. That's one way to work on stopping your chicken winging. Hopefully, let's see how this works. Hopefully it works. Try that at home, guys. So I've decided not to cover the defense. I'll do this, the street defense in another video. I might put that one out tomorrow or the day after. Yeah. So watch out for the street defense, for your self-defense, how to defend yourself against the barrage of punches on my next video. I'm not putting it in this one. Enjoy! Ha ha.